Hello and most welcome to 1497 of the Heidegger series. We will today continue with Wittgenstein, Rethinking the Inner by Paul Johnston. And we are presently debating thought, thinking. So perception was previous chapter 2, and now we are easing into thinking. Wittgenstein is once more setting up an example by a dummy. Connected to blindness, last chapter it was the aspect blind, and now we are dealing with a meaning blind person. See the idea that the meaning blind has an inner speech or imagery ends up problematic. Many sides of the example is taken up. It is almost like art. He is trying to get closer and closer to the very kernel of the problem. I will not start exactly where I left off, but make a swift repetition from the third paragraph of page 76. As these points suggest, this first conception of meaning blindness is flawed. In fact, it still contains the problem with which we started. Despite appearances, the lightning speed of thought has not been eliminated at all. For example, the meaning blind man intends to go and see his friend N. since all his intentions are explicit, having this intention will involve him saying to himself, I will now go and see N. But who does he mean by N? Presumably, the meaning blind man will be able to answer this question. But in that case, even his explicit intention has the problem of the lightning speed of thought built into it. In explaining what his intention statement meant, the meaning blind man is doing precisely what he is not supposed to be able to do. the only way to avoid this problem would be if we assumed that the meaning-blind man's thoughts were always fully explicit. This idea does not make sense, for whatever he says to himself, it will always be possible to seek further elucidation of what his words mean. Thus, Wittgenstein's first conception of meaning blindness goes both too far and not far enough. one hand, the meaning-blind man's inability to offer continuous explanations of his actions undermines his intentionality. On the other hand, the explanations he does offer still embody the puzzling phenomenon of the lightning speed of thought. These problems, Wittgenstein tries another approach. this time, instead of emphasizing the experience at the time of speaking or acting, he seeks to eliminate it. Instead of stressing the experience in the past, he emphasizes the fact that the individual is now inclined to offer a particular explanation. Previous approach, the difference between us and the meaning blind man was that he always had an image where we only sometimes have one. Now he is someone who never experiencing anything at the time of speaking, and therefore has no temptation to treat the explanation he offers as somehow inherent in an experience in the past. If, for example, he says, "I hope to see N soon," he will understand the question, "Who do you mean by N?" But not the question, "Who did you mean by N?" So he cannot reach meaning. Answer the other language game which concerns meaning. It's also a language game, but for some reason he doesn't have access to it. This approach eliminates any reference to a past experience and so avoids the problem of the lightning speed of thought. By implication, it suggests that our reference to the past is simply a misleading metaphor. the use of a peculiar picture. Consideration of what actually happens when we talk seems to support this analysis. If someone says to me and has written to me, I can ask him, which end do you mean? And I must refer to an experience in speaking the name if he is to answer me, and if he now simply pronounces the name N, perhaps as an introduction to a statement about N. I equally well ask him, whom do you mean? And he equally well answer. Well, good point. And I think we end there, because now we are well into the problems with meaning and how meaning cannot be transferred into inner speech nor image. Very seldom or unusually do we have an image when we mean something. It seems to be entirely different altogether. A bit like art, it's a bit like music. Wittgenstein is most definitely different. He does not use proof. Some arguments there are, and some pointers, but it's so open, quite different from normal philosophical or academic discourse of modern day. I say thank you very much and have a very pleasant afternoon. Bye bye for now.